So let's go ahead and again start this one. And what we always do now is start with the corners, because when you do a corner, you're going to have tapered joints and other joints here that run into the corner. You don't want to overlap the tape. So it's essential that you do not do that. So you have to do the corners first. So let's talk about corners for just a second. The tape comes with a natural crease down the center. And if you bend it like that, it allows you to put the tape into the corner a lot easier. So what we do is make sure that that crease is down when we feed it through the fast little taper. And we hold it down with our thumb. Then we submerge it into about an inch past the actual tooth or the finger itself on the inside finger. So about that deep. And then we slowly pull that through. And what you want to do is constantly check to make sure that the tape comes out like this all the time with those grooves in it. Now, what the fast little taper does is put more in the center so it'll penetrate the joints better. And because we put it on that crease side, we take it right over to the corner and we walk it down in the center of the joint with our fingers to the end of the tape. And we'll go back and smooth out about a foot at a time on either side of a corner, so you're walking it consistently. And of course you want to make sure it squeezes out the other end. Then you make a cleanup pass each time. If you penetrate the corner with the knife edge and you tear it, change it right now, because you'll have problems with it later. So now we're going to take another piece and we're going to go down just about half that distance. And again, you can either tear it, and I'm going to do that for you right now. You can crease it. Again, we want it down so the corner's down, that crease. We take our fast little taper, we feed it through, hold it down about 3/4 of an inch, submerge it into the tape. Make sure that there's plenty of compound in front of the tape. That's where it's picking up the compound, in the front, not the back. And again, of course, we do not want to pre-water the tape. And as we pull this through, that's the consistency we get. So now we're going to wipe the knife off. And again, we're going to turn this upside down. So we have this part of the tape that came out has all the compound on it. That was the last part. The first 2 or 3 inches, it doesn't have any compound on it. So we're going to put this, we're going to butt it right up next to that other tape, walk it down with our fingers, center it right in the joint, come back and smooth that out about a foot at a time. If you see any wrinkles, if you see any bubbles, stop and smooth them out right now. This is going to save you, though, so much time over pre-mudding the joint by hand and then trying to embed the tape into it. So now we continue tearing our tape. Make sure that the crease is on the inside, on the bottom. We feed that through. We hold it down, same as before. If you set this in more of the center of the bucket, you'll get all the compound you want. And you can see that I'm going to get my hand out of the way. You can see how much is coming out on that. That's a lot of compound. It's okay. It'll smooth out. This is the one that we want all the way in the bottom. Sometimes it's a little bit difficult to get them in the corners. Okay, so you feed that in there like that. Now, same thing. Go about a foot at a time, but on the bottom, you want to come up. You don't want to go down, because this is going to be a common occurrence with the device. I'm going to take that overlap out in a minute. If I went down this way, I'd hit the deck first, and you don't want that. You want to come all the way up, Make a cleanup pass. Now, you see where that overlapped? That's actually pretty smooth. In fact, that's smooth enough. That's not like that's gonna cause any trouble on your second coat. When we get these joints done, what I always do is now come back in with the wet sponge, moist sponge, and just sponge off all that excess. When you go to do your second coat, it's a lot smoother. So now let's move on to that second joint.
About every 5 to 8 pieces of tape that you run through, sometimes the teeth will build up. And if it's a hot summer day, it'll start to dry out on you and fill the teeth in. Submerge it into your cleanup water. Shake it around a little bit. Take your toothbrush if you need it, but just by doing that, as you can see, it's cleaned the teeth out, and that'll allow you to go back to work right now.